home. If not, I can get you the book and send it to you. And I get to read it to you so you can watch whenever you want. So, this one's called The Very Hungry Caterpillar. And I chose this one because Mom used to read this one to me when I was a kid. My hands are all colored because I was just making t-shirts. I had a bunch of fun stuff for us today. Okay, so it says, for my sister, Christina. Don't know who that is. Very Hungry Caterpillar by Eric Carley.
Open your book, love.
In the light of the moon, a little
first
egg
page.
Lay on a leaf. Right
there we go.
One Sunday morning, the warm sun came up, and pop, out of the egg came a tiny and very hungry caterpillar. So there's a sun. Baked. He started to look for some food. So there he is. Says on Monday, he ate through one apple, but he was still hungry. There's an apple right there. See, there's a hole. There he is. On Tuesday, he ate through two pears, but he was still hungry. So there's two pears. He ate right through them. There he is. On Wednesday, he ate through three plums, but he was still hungry. Woohoo! It's like me after the gym. There he is. On Thursday, he ate through four strawberries, but he was still hungry. Four strawberries ain't that much. There he is. On Friday, he ate through five oranges, but he was still hungry. Lawad! On Saturday, he ate through one piece of chocolate cake, one ice cream cone, one pickle, one slice of Swiss cheese, one slice of salami, one lollipop, one piece of cherry pie, one sausage, one cupcake, and one slice of watermelon. But that night, he had a stomachache. Why you don't eat all that together? You can eat that much. It's not those weird things all at once. It'll make you feel weird. The next day was Sunday again. The caterpillar ate through one nice green leaf. And after that, he felt much better. That's why you gotta eat your veggies after all those treats. Because one singular leaf of lettuce will make you feel much better, according to this. Now he wasn't hungry anymore. And he wasn't a little caterpillar anymore. He was a big fat caterpillar. Gross. He built a small house called a cocoon around himself. He stayed inside for more than 2 weeks. He then nibbled a hole in the cocoon and pushed his way out and... oh, suspense. He was a butterfly. A beautiful butterfly, mind you. Look at that. Hey! And that's the end of the story. So if you eat a whole lot of food every day for a whole week and get real fat, you'll turn into a butterfly. That's true. Well, that's the end of the book. Hopefully they'll be sending this one home with you. If not, I will order it for you so you can have it. I will talk to all you guys soon, and I'll see you soon, Brandon.
Bye. Can I see that again?
Yes, we can watch it as many times as you want.